Welcome back to Astronaut. It's time for Newton's third and final law of motion. Newton's third law of motion states that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. By equal, we simply mean that the forces share the same magnitude, or strength. By opposite, we mean that the forces act in opposite directions. This means that if you push on something, it'll push back. If a boxer strikes a punching bag, for example, the bag will exert a force back on the boxer's fist that equals the force of the initial punch. If we consider this in tangent with Newton's second law, force equals mass times acceleration, then we can say the more mass of the punching bag, the greater the force required to get the bag to move. With that in mind, the more mass of the punching bag, the greater the force exerted back on the boxer's fist will be as well. We must also consider the weight of objects. Although we often use the terms weight and mass interchangeably, weight is actually a force that is dependent on where you reside. Weight is equal to an object's mass times its acceleration. On Earth, an object's acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared. So the weight of a 12 kilogram chair on Earth is 12 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared, or about 117.6 newtons. According to Newton's third law, the Earth reacts to the chair with the same force. We call this upward force exerted by the Earth the normal force. Another example of Newton's third law in action is a car crash. When two cars collide, the force applied to both is the same. If the first car is an 8,000 kilogram truck and the second car is 1,000 kilograms, what will be their accelerations relative to each other? The acceleration of the smaller vehicle will be larger than the truck. More specifically, because mass and acceleration are inversely related to each other, the acceleration of the smaller vehicle will be 8 times greater than the acceleration of the larger vehicle. Let's summarize Newton's three laws of motion. 1. An object in motion will stay in motion, and an object at rest will stay at rest until an external force disturbs the object. 2. The net force acting on an object is equal to its mass times its acceleration. And 3, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction.